Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. It's Amin here, and today I'm doing a video that's all about what I wear on a regular basis or some of the essentials that I have in my wardrobe that I wear a lot. So if you have been on my channel before, you might know that I have a lot of clothing items. I've done a few closet cleanouts so far, and I'm actually going to be doing another one this month. So definitely subscribe if you want to see that. But if you've seen any of those videos, you know I have a lot of clothes. So I thought it would be fun if I kind of went through all my belongings and picked out the items that I think were most essential to my style and what I wear most often and share them with you. Also, as an aside, I do have an Instagram that's kind of like a fashion style diary where I share a lot of my outfits. So if you're interested in seeing how I put together these pieces, definitely go and follow me on Instagram. But besides that, let's get into some of these items. I think we can start with the bottoms first. So I'm an oversharer. There will be a lot of asides, a lot of stories in this video. So when I was in high school, I used to basically only wear sweatpants. And I just feel like back in the day, a lot of the jeans were not comfortable and they were still like low rise. The high rise trend didn't fully start yet. So I wore sweatpants a lot up until I started university. And then for some reason, like I just fell off the sweatpant trend and I just wore jeans all the time in university. And I feel like that has still seeped into my life now. So the first item that I have are actually a pair of jeans, and I used to work at American Eagle. I love American Eagle. I love Aerie. I wish they would sponsor me. Maybe that will be my goal for this channel, is to get a sponsorship from Aerie or American Eagle. But the first pair of pants that I have is these mom jeans. So I'll show you a clip of me trying them on, but I definitely wear these jeans like at least once a week. They're super, super comfortable. They're from the Curvy line on American Eagle. And the size that I wear is 12 short. I really like their jeans because they're super stretchy, they're really high-waisted, and they're comfortable, and they actually fit me like mom jeans are supposed to fit me. I find that a lot of jeans don't fit me the way that they are meant to be styled. Like, I know skinny jeans are not trendy anymore, and now straight jeans are in, but I just haven't been able to find a pair of straight jeans that actually look like straight jeans on me. A lot of trends that we see in fashion are not made for people who look like me, even though there are a lot of us. So what I mean to say is the Curvy line at American Eagle is amazing and I super recommend it. I think all of my jeans, except like one, are from the American Eagle Curvy line. So that's just an aside if you're looking for a pair of jeans that is comfortable and stretchy and high-waisted and that will fit your bum properly. I highly recommend the American Eagle Curvy line. But anyways, these are mom jeans. I really like the fact that they, like I said, they fit me well. They actually look like mom jeans and they're just super comfortable. I've had them for about 2 years now, and unfortunately, I don't think they carry the specific style anymore. I bought the newer version of the mom jeans they have at American Eagle and they just don't have the same stretch to them. So I'm really happy that I snagged this pair when I worked there, and I will keep them until they literally fall off my body. The next pair of bottoms that I have is also from Aerie. So these are actually bike shorts, and these ones, I actually have two pairs of bike shorts. This one is the more athletic material, and then I have a more cotton material. I really like bike shorts for multiple reasons, especially these ones, because since they are athletic, I actually can work out in them. They're super, super high-waisted, which I really enjoy, and they kind of like suck you in as if they're compression shorts. They also have pockets on the side, which I really like. And I like how you can wear bike shorts on their own. They're super versatile. You can dress them up, dress them down, but you can also wear them underneath things. So I tend to wear bike shorts or shorts underneath all my dresses because of chub rub and chafing and all of that. So I just like how these are super comfortable, athletic material, breathable, but also very in style right now. And then moving on to my tops, I only have one top to share, which is actually insane, and it is this mock neck. So like I said, if you follow me on Instagram, I wear like this mock neck all the time. I actually have two of the same shirt. So this mock neck is from a brand called Frank and Oak, which is a sustainable Canadian brand. And I originally bought this in black, and then I actually bought another one in this cream color. and I wear them all the time. I find that you can really layer them easily. You can wear like tank tops on top, you can wear things underneath, you can dress them up, dress them down. Like I've worn them to clinic as an office outfit, or I've also worn them casually. And I just like that it's a thin material, it's like a t-shirt material. So it also like, I think a lot of these outfits are dependent on the seasons or the area that you live in. So the area that I'm in is like the Toronto or New York area, which means we have four seasons. So I just like having transitional pieces that I can wear many times throughout the year. And this one is definitely one of the most comfortable. I like how it's a mock neck and not a turtleneck because it just like sits the right way. Whereas in a turtleneck, sometimes you have to like fold it and it can like get a little bit messed up. But I think this is an amazing piece and I absolutely love Frank and Oak. And I think once I have a salary, I'll start spending some more money on sustainable items. But as of right now, I'm really happy with this specific purchase. Then let's move on to dresses. I only have one again. More of a type of style of dress, and that is t-shirt dresses. So I have been wearing t-shirt dresses for years. I have a few of these in my closet in different colors. And I have one that's like gray and striped, one that's long sleeve, and then I have this black one is here as well. And this one is from Old Navy. It's nothing special. It just is super comfortable. Sometimes I just don't wanna wear like a top and a bottom. Like I don't wanna have to dress that up. So just wearing a dress is really nice. And then on top of it, one that's breathable, made of cotton. You can wear bike shorts underneath, and then you can just dress it up or dress it down however you want to. Usually I would like style this with some sneakers and a denim jacket. But like I said, you can also dress it up if you wanted to, but I just like having like a one-stop shop outfit. Literally just throw this on and then I look like I'm put together because it's a dress, but in reality, it's literally just an oversized t-shirt. Then for outerwear, I don't even know if this counts as outerwear, but a layering piece. I love denim jackets. So I actually have two different denim jackets. This one that I'm trying on right now is an oversized boyfriend fit, but I'm pretty sure I actually bought this from the men's section at Forever 21. I've been looking for an oversized denim jacket for many years, but the ones in the women's section like just didn't fit me the right way. Again, I think it has to do with like being more curvy, and like the oversized items in the women's section are never actually oversized for me. So I just went to the men's section and then I bought this oversized denim jacket a couple of years ago, and I wear it almost every day. Like it's just so easy to style and you can just throw on top of anything, and it has pockets, so it's nice to like carry things like hand sanitizer. But I also have a cropped version of a denim jacket that I wear less often now. I think I used to wear it more a few years ago, but then this one, it just looks trendy, baggy, comfortable, and I just really like it. And then in terms of undergarments, I did not make a video clip of me trying this on just because I don't really want to be wearing my underwear on the internet, but I have a bralette here. And this is another thing, if somebody, I hope this is helpful if you are like curvier and have like a bigger chest, because bralettes are all the rave and everyone wears them and they're super trendy, super comfortable, but I just never was able to find one that fit me well and supported me in the way that I wanted it to until I bought these bralettes. So I don't even know if these are available anymore. If they are, I'll put everything in the description box below, but these are from Aerie. I have this bralette in three different colors because I bought one in an extra large and then I tried it and I was like, oh my gosh, I understand why everyone loves bralettes. And then I bought two others in different colors, and I wear these like in public, I wear them at home. They're just really cute, really comfortable, and like they don't have any padding in them, which is what I was surprised I liked, because I thought I needed something with padding, I needed something with underwire, but it turns out like I just need to step out of my comfort zone and trust that it could work, and it did. So this is just a really simple, cute bralette. It has some lace on the bottom and it's just cute for like lounging around, but also nice and comfortable and supported. And then the last couple of items I have, the first thing are a pair of sneakers. Funny story about these sneakers. I have plantar fasciitis, which just means I have flat feet. And my mom bought me these shoes from Costco. They're obviously like, the brand is Adidas, but they're also really dirty because I wear them everywhere. But she bought me these from Costco because they're specially made for people with flat feet, like they have more arch support. And she bought them for me and I was like, ugh, what the heck? They're so ugly, they're like mom shoes. And I never wore them for like a year or two. Then I brought them with me to New York and That's when like I feel like the white sneaker trend really took off, like a couple of years ago. Everyone was wearing white sneakers, and then I tried these on and I was like, am I walking on a cloud? It was just like amazing. And now I wear them so much, like I'm worried I'll have to get rid of them soon because they're like not in great shape anymore. But they're just like super easy to wear. I literally wear them like every other day, I would say. And they work with most of my outfits because I'm a casual dresser. So wearing sneakers with anything is like the perfect way to end off an outfit. So I've been wearing these for a really long time now, and they're fraying and they're ugly. Like maybe I'll try to put them in like the washing machine later on, I don't know. But I highly recommend having a pair of comfortable shoes. I have a pair of black sneakers as well, or black running shoes. I guess these are running shoes. I have black running shoes and I have white ones, and I've just been reaching for the white ones a lot more than the black ones. So definitely recommend having a good pair of sneakers that are comfortable enough for you to walk in. And then the last item I have is just jewelry. So if you've been watching my videos for a while, you know that I typically have hoops on my ears at all times. So I have 3 piercings on each ear, and I really just have like these hoops. They were originally gold, but then they just like faded into like a silver gold color. So which kind of works for me because sometimes I do wear silver jewelry, sometimes I wear gold jewelry. So they just kind of match with everything, and I got them from Amazon. I don't recommend them by any means. Obviously the color came off, but just for making things work in the moment, they're fine. And then I have this one larger hoop. These I just got like a pack of 6 pairs of earrings from H&M or something, and I've been wearing those. But I actually have like, I have rose gold hoops, I have silver hoops from different brands. So honestly, like any simple jewelry is kind of what I've been leaning towards more recently. I used to be the type of person that only wore studs, so I would have like silver studs on both of my smaller piercings and then bigger studs on like my first piercing. But I feel like it's more casual and also a little bit more professional to have like less flashier jewelry. So that's kind of what I have been leaning towards these last couple of years, and I think that's what I'm gonna try to continue on. I have a lot of jewelry and I've had them for years, and I feel like I need to sort out what I really like, but this is definitely what I have been reaching for like the last year or two. And that way I can just like make sure I look like I'm ready, I'm dressed up, even though I'm literally wearing the same earrings I wear every single day. So that definitely helps in terms of making myself feel more put together, and then my outfits look more put together as well. And with that, I think I shared 8 different items that I have as part of essentials in my wardrobe. I hope this video was helpful, especially if you are somebody who relates to being more curvy or have a difficult time finding things that are staples in your wardrobe. I've been wearing all of these items for at least a year, so I think it's pretty safe to say that they are my favorite pieces, the ones that I reach for the most. And if you enjoyed this video, of course, give it a thumbs up. If you have any suggestions for what you would like to see, if you want to see me style these pieces, of course, look over on my Instagram. But if you want a video of that, I would be more than happy to make that as well. If you want to see more of my content, subscribe to this channel. And of course, thank you for watching, and I will see you next time. Bye.